Come on, slow people.
Justin, we're going to be late.
I know. Hey, Eagles, I'm Jay.
And I'm Michaela.
And this is ETV. And we're about to be late to school.
Why don't we go to On the Streets while we waste time?
All right, cool.
Hey, I'm Myra.
Hey, and I'm Brian, and we're on the streets
to see who you're taking to homecoming.
My girlfriend.
My boyfriend from out of town. I am taking an Oiler football player.
No one, I'm going to homecoming
date. Me? Is this a joke?
No.
I never went to homecoming. I wasn't popular. Who would like to take me?
I'm taking Chelsea Ventures to homecoming. I love you, babe.
LaKeisha Crawford, she's my homecoming date. I love her. I've been with her for 2 years, and I love you so much.
I'm going to homecoming with my boyfriend, Cortland.
Well, I'm going with David, and he goes to Turner. And I'm going with Carlos, who goes to Man.
Friend.
Is that awkward?
Bae. Sure, I know who she is.
Say my name.
What's up, guys? Welcome to Film Fridays.
Second episode of the year. Now that the summer movie season is over, we're going to be transferring over to the
Oscar season.
Let's take a look. First on the list is The Martian, starring Matt Damon. This movie comes out October 2nd. It's about astronaut Mark Watney, who is lost on Mars and needs to find a way to survive and get back home. Second would be Black Mass, starring Johnny Depp and Benedict Cumberbatch. Johnny Depp actually plays a mob boss, so I'm pretty excited for that.
Another movie that has Oscar buzz is The Revenant, starring Leonardo DiCaprio and directed by Alejandro Iñárritu, who is also the director of Birdman. Hopefully, Leo will win an Oscar this time. Please, Academy, give him an Oscar. Another movie that has a lot of anticipation is the movie Steve Jobs, starring Michael Fassbender and Seth Rogen.
Alright guys, that's it for Film Fridays. Here's some movies you can see this weekend.
The Visit.
The Perfect Guy.
Hitman Agent 47.
And Transporter Refueled.
Alright, see you later.
So, this weekend, we went and saw Motley Crue on their final tour.
And Alice Cooper. Yeah.
All right. It was pretty great.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. Okay. Motley Crue.
They were, of course, pretty just awesome. Honestly, the biggest part was the Tommy Lee drum roller coaster.
Oh, yeah. That was crazy. So what this basically was like this huge roller coaster from the stage to the control room where the drummer got connected to it, and he was like flying over the crowd, and then he went upside down. He was literally drumming upside
also,
down.
Nikki Sixx's flamethrower bass.
Oh, yeah. Flamethrower bass. That was
pretty
cool.
Pretty great, man. Yeah. So Motley Crue goes off running through the crowd with flashlights along the ground. And they get to the control point where they did the drum coaster. The entire band, except for the guitarist, gets on stage. And the guitarist is still up on the normal stage. But the other guys are on this other stage. And it just starts, like, rising up. Yeah. And they start playing Home Sweet Home, which is, their flagship song.
Yeah,
like,
so
good. Yeah. Like, ridiculously. But, all right. Well, thank you all for listening today and watching.
All right, guys.
I guess we'll see you next time we go to a concert.
Come on.
Hey, what do I wear next week for homecoming?
I think you should take some advice from Kim and Chelsea.
I think I'm supposed to wear my mom every day, not just Friday.
Ask them, it's all right.
Okay.
Hey Eagles, so you know next week's homecoming, right? We have a specific dress code for every day of the week for you.
Okay, so Monday we have Disney Day.
Tuesday we have Twin Day.
Wednesday is Crazy Hair Day.
Thursday we have Throwback Day.
And Friday, Mom Day!
Hey Eagles. Be sure to come out to our annual flock party this upcoming Wednesday from 6 to 8. We'll have food, games, and not to forget our famous haunted house. We'll be having our pep rally next Friday. Tickets will be on sale for $3. Also, don't forget about our homecoming dance. It's from 9 to 12 after the game. Pre-sale will be $7 and $10 at the door. Attire is dress casual, so just come as you are. Hope to see y'all there.
Kristen, what are you doing?
Listening to my husband, Drake.
Are you kidding me? J. Cole is so much better than Drake.
No, he's not.
Yes, he is.
Drake is better.
No, J. Cole is way better.
Drake.
J. Cole.
Drake.
J. Cole.
Drake.
Drizzy.
Worst. Oh, Drake, baby.
Worst.
Hey. I mean, Drake got emotional, but
you know, I'm always in my feelings, so Drake is the main.
Drake.
Worst.
J. Cole.
Cole.
Drake.
Worst.
Drake.
Worst.
Drake.
Worst.
Girl.
Drake.
Who sings this?
Demi Lovato.
Okay, not you, so stop.
Do you mean? When you nod
can
your
you
head,
change
yes.
the song?
What do you mean? No, I cannot change the song. This is my favorite song.
This is not even trendy.
Yes, it is. But you know what? If you want more what's trending music, why don't we go to Kelly and Jenna to find out more?
Hi, I'm Kelly.
And I'm Jenna.
And this is what's trending. This week, we're going to be talking about a referee getting hit,
Taylor Swift,
and a plane catching on fire. Two high school football players are suspended and are being accused of intentionally hitting a ref and diving into him. And the coach has been fired right now, but they're still trying to prove that he told them to do that. That's so sad.
This past Wednesday, Taylor Swift came to Minute Maid Park on her tour in 1989. The show was sold out with 45,000 people there. I was there and it was a really great show.
Also, this past Wednesday, a British Airways plane was taking off in Las Vegas and it caught on fire. There were 159 passengers and 13 crew members, and 13 people were injured. It's pretty sad, but everything's okay now. So that's all for this week on What's Trending.
Bye.
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 Today, our fellow citizens, our way of life, our very freedom came under attack in a series of deliberate and deadly terrorist acts.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky.
Oh, hello there, and welcome to Nathan's Homecoming Proposal Tips. Today, I will show you how to propose to a homecoming queen. Hi, I'm just wanting to know, would you go to homecoming with me?
Not this year. Sorry.
Will you go with me to homecoming?
Of course, Nathan. I'd love to. Would you like to go to homecoming with me? Come on, please.
Yes, of course. Let's go. Hey, hey, hi, hi. Will you go with me to homecoming?
No, thank you.
Would you go with me to homecoming?
I'd be honored to go to homecoming with you, but I'm married. A little issue.
Will you go with me to homecoming?
No, thanks.
Will you go with me to homecoming?
Sure. Boy!
I'll see you. Pick you up at 10.
All right.
All right, Eagles. There are your helpful tips for getting a homecoming queen of your own. Now, in all seriousness, I really need to make a homecoming proposal of my own. Cameron Ashley Madison, would you please come with me to homecoming? I would be very honored if you would.
Oh, excuse me. How are y'all doing today? I didn't see you there. I just wanted to bring to you, the Austin Eagles, a brief presentation on how to prevent getting sick, you know. There's been a slight sickness going around the school. We believe it to be a cold, but I believe there are many methods of prevention that we can all partake in, if you will. Please, let's continue.
Step one, as you proceed out of the local restroom, wash your hands for more than 20 seconds. Please. It's gross if you don't. Step two, proceed to the nearest paper towel dispenser. Dry them hands. Dry them good in between your fingers and underneath your nails. I tell you what, dry them suckers. That's nasty. You gotta get all that gross water from underneath it. Step three, final step. Proceed to the nearest hand sanitizer or hand sanitizing dispenser and sanitize your hands because they still might have germs on them after you wash them poorly. Thank you, Dawson High School, for participating in this step-by-step guide to washing your hands and sanitizing. I hope that everything goes fine with this gross epidemic going around, everyone getting sick, because you never know, you might end up with a cold, and just know, whoever gave it to you, more than likely did not wash their hands correctly. Thank you. Have a great day, Eagles.
Hey, Eagles, I'm Matt.
And I'm Christian.
And this is
ESN. Wednesday, your girls volleyball played another killer game, scoring a maximum of 25 in each set against Pasadena Memorial. Great job, ladies.
Friday, your boys and girls cross country competed at Clear Lake. For the boys, Matthew Murray finished in fifth place, and for the girls, Abby Harrelson once again finished in first place. Great job, guys. The next meet is today in South Houston. Good luck to you all.
Friday, our boys faced off against Magnolia West with a crushing victory of 47-23. With less mistakes, the offense and defense came out stronger than ever. Quarterback Zach Smith passed over 200 yards, and the defense held them scoreless for two whole quarters. Great job, Eagles. Come out tonight at Memorial Stadium to watch them face the Alvin Yellow Jackets.
Well, Eagles, I'm Matthew.
And I'm Christian.
And this was
ESN.
All right, and we're turning this off now.
Why did you turn it off?
Because you're about to pull in the parking lot.
It was telling us important dates.
Wait, what date?
The TSR Part 1 and okay. The MYTN are both due on Monday for all teachers.
Wait, isn't Flock Party and Homecoming next week also?
Yeah, Flock Party's on Wednesday and Homecoming's on Friday. I hope to see you there.
All right, cool. All right, well, there you have it, Eagles. I'm Jay.
And I'm Michaela.
And this was ETV. We hope to see you Monday in your Disney costumes.
Party!
Track, bruh.